Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, the 54th commencement for the University of California, Irvine is assembled. Please rise and join Vermilion Vocalists, a UCI a cappella group, in singing the national anthem.
So proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say, does that star-spangled
thank you, Vermilion Vocalists, and good afternoon to all of you. How are you feeling? I don't even need to ask you to do that again. That was great. My name is Enrique Lavernia, and I have the privilege of serving as our campus's provost and executive vice chancellor So on behalf of UCI, I want to welcome to the commencement ceremony for the School of Humanities and the School of Social Ecology, all of you gathered here, and especially our fathers in the audience. Happy Father's Day to everyone. So, joining me today on the platform are the following chief academic and administrative officers of the university and other participants in the ceremony. When I call your name, I'd like you to stand and remain standing. Audience, please hold your applause. Starting on my right, Professor Ian Collar, Baccalaureate Candidates Marshal. Julia Emerson, UCI Alumni Association, Class of 1997, and our Mace Marshal. Susan Charles, Associate Dean, Graduate Division. Our student speaker, Daree Smith, Baccalaureate Candidate, School of Humanities. Tyrus Miller, our Dean of Humanities. Our featured speaker, Jim Guerinot, owner of Rebel Waltz. Edgar Dormitorio, our Interim Vice Chancellor for Student Affairs. Nancy Guerra, our Dean of Social Ecology. Michael Denon, Vice Provost for Teaching and Learning and Dean, Division of Undergraduate Education. Brian Hervey, Vice Chancellor, University Advancement and Alumni Relations. Professor Peter Krapp, our University Marshal. Professor Beth Kaufman, Master's Marshal. And Professor Mona Lynch, Platform Party Marshal. In addition, I would like to acknowledge the presence on the platform of many of our outstanding distinguished faculty. Will the faculty please stand? Thank you all. You may be seated. So, last Friday, I had the privilege of attending commencement ceremonies at Aalto University in Helsinki, Finland. And as I reflect on the speeches that I heard, many of them in Swedish and Finnish, and fortunately a few in English, it occurred to me that there's a number of core values that UCI shares with Aalto, despite the differences in history, Aalto being several hundred years old and UCI being 53. First was their evident pride of the diversity of their student body, which included students from Africa, Sweden, India, Iran, Pakistan, Finland, Russia, Turkey, and even a few North Americans. You see, a few years back when I visited Aalto, there was almost no diversity amongst the student body. Diversity is an important value at UCI, since we know that you cannot have excellence without diversity. Second was the expectation and optimism of the critical role that Aalto students will play in their national vision for success. Similarly, at UCI, we are confident that our students graduate with the skills necessary to tackle the ever-increasing challenges that we face as a society. Third was Aalto's emphasis on sustainability and social access, which are important in Finland. We know how much we cherish these values here at UCI, and your class provides many examples of this commitment. Sometimes I hear comments about your generation, that you're selfish, that you're entitled, that you don't have any interest for deep engagement. In my view, those comments are misguided. Your awareness and activities around environmental issues, your deep commitment to social justice and diversity, and your mastery of technology far exceeds that of prior generations. So I know that you will make this world a better place for all of us to live in. Today, your life journey continues. Yes, it is a special day because you are here is a testament to your dedication and hard work. Our fantastic faculty, our dedicated staff, and our hardworking administrators are profoundly grateful to you for allowing us to be part of your journey. And so, as each of you continues in your own journey, may you set high goals for your destination. May you find time to enjoy your journey. And yes, it is okay to take a few side trips. May you take time to appreciate those who join you in your journey. And may you never look back with regret. In fact, there's an old Finnish saying, and I quote, "Who asks for the road doesn't get lost." That is to say, don't be afraid to ask for help. Finally, Thank you to each and every one of you for what you have taught us during our journey together. Again, on behalf of the UCI family, I wish you good luck and congratulations. Thank you. And now, Interim Vice Chancellor Dormitorio, please come forward to introduce our student speaker.
Thank you, Provost Lavernia. It is a pleasure to introduce our student speaker, Darice Smith. Darice Smith served for 7 years in the U.S. Army as a captain and OH-58D Kiowa helicopter pilot. She grew up in Jacksonville, Florida, and has been married to her husband, Jeff, for 17 years. They have a 7-year-old son, Devin. Darice earned her first bachelor's degree in English from Davidson College, outside of Charlotte, North Carolina. After the Army, she attempted careers in sales, customer service, and stand-up comedy, but decided writing was her true passion. She enjoys open water swimming and Brazilian jiu-jitsu, and plans on pursuing a career as a freelance writer after graduation. Please join me in welcoming Darice.
To the faculty and students of Humanities and Social Ecology, good afternoon. My name is Darice Smith, and like you, today, I am graduating with a degree from UC Irvine, mine being in literary journalism. That's right. For me, though, I am graduating later in life after spending 7 years in the Army as a helicopter pilot, and after already earning a bachelor's degree from English from Davidson College. Today, I want to talk to you about the opportunities that come from failure. In the fall of 2016, I discovered an interesting story idea while I tried to balance being a stay-at-home mom and a freelance writer. The story was about the largest drug interdiction seizure of opium in Afghanistan since 2003. And how we were using these old Soviet-era helicopters to conduct these missions. I found pilots who were willing to talk and thought, that's it, I have a story. I persistently pitched the story to Aaron Smith's Smithsonian magazine, and after the editors realized I wasn't going away, they assigned me a feature story on the mission. I did what I thought I should do, interviewed the pilots, one even from Afghanistan, and I got what I thought was the whole story. I turned it in and waited impatiently for their response. Unfortunately, they didn't come back with the suggested edits, but instead told me, thanks, but no thanks. I was devastated because I thought I had done a good job, and I thought I was a good writer. I realized, though, that my education as a writer was incomplete and began looking for options for improvement. Ever since I had read and loved the book Seabiscuit, I knew I wanted to be a nonfiction writer. Life got in the way, though, for a very long time. I deployed to Iraq from 2005 to 2006 and experienced several traumatic moments that left its mark on me, including PTSD and horrible chronic back pain. I struggled transitioning into the civilian world, and I had a series of crappy jobs that left me unfulfilled, including a few soul-sucking sales jobs and a stint in customer service for a cell phone company. All the while, I had this idea of becoming a writer, but who becomes a writer? How impractical is that? I know many of you are stressing about what you want to pursue as a career, and you think you should have it figured out by now. It took me 12 years after the Army to figure out what I wanted to do when I grew up. On Google search hour number 100, I discovered that UC Irvine has a literary journalism program. I read the major description and everything clicked. Not only was there a new name for the kind of writing I wanted to do, but I could study it exclusively. I expected to learn a bit about reporting and interviewing, and that I would get to practice some writing. I had no idea how much the literary journalism program would far, far exceed my expectations. Of course, I got to take actual courses in reporting and participated in several writing workshops. I learned about the sometimes murky ethical boundaries of journalism. Outside of the literary journalism program, I was able to conduct 2 whole quarters of research about a topic that I hoped to write a book about, and this was in the history department. Then I even became proficient in German, a language that I hadn't spoken in 20 years. While the classes were interesting, the professors and students made my experience exceptional. Every professor had an impact on me in some way, and their willingness to help me professionally and personally was absolutely remarkable. I didn't think I would have anything in common with the younger students, but I made many friends. Now I am a full-time freelance writer, and though difficult, I'm living my dream. What I want to leave you with is that some of the greatest things in life occur out of failure. I really hate to use that word because so much good can come out of it. Perhaps I'll call it disappointment. If I had not been rejected by Air and Space, I would have never had this wonderful experience at UC Irvine. I would be an inferior writer, and I would have no network of students and professors who genuinely wanted to see me succeed. Failure is inevitable, and thank goodness for it. When it happens to you, and it might happen several times, look to the other side of it for the greater opportunity and roll with it. Congratulations to everyone here.
Thank you, Doris. It's now our pleasure to introduce our featured speaker, Jim Guarineau. Jim Guarineau is the owner of Rebel Waltz, an entertainment company based in Laguna Beach, California. Previous management clients include Beck, Social Distortion, Nine Inch Nails, Gwen Stefani and No Doubt, Rancid, Chris Cornell, The Offspring, and Robbie Robertson. Prior to this, Jim was a concert promoter and the general manager of AMM Records. Jim graduated from UC Irvine in 1985 with a bachelor's degree in English. Jim co-wrote the book for young people, Legends, Icons, and Rebels, Rock History, which was published in 2013. He also filled in as producer of the documentary film, 20 Feet from Stardom, when his friend and mentor from A&M Records, Gil Frisane, passed away. The film went on to win the Academy Award for Best Documentary. 2019 is the fourth year that Jim has taught AP US History for 11th graders in a 1-week, 20-hour series focused on the 1960s. He has 4 children, Emily, Luke, Veronica, and Jessica. Please join me in a warm welcome for Jim Guarineau.
Hello, hello. Thank you, Dean Miller. Welcome, faculty, family, friends, graduates, congratulations. Come on. It's terrific. Thank you. I was a little surprised to be asked to do this, quite frankly. I left high school in 1976. I didn't graduate till 1985. You can do the math. I think Dean Miller and his office were playing a little game of what one thing is not like the other. Nevertheless, I'm here, and once I got here, you know, it's interesting, Doris, you spoke about failure. I investigated a little bit of the commencement speech. You know, you go on YouTube and start checking these things out. Probably a colossal mistake, but I start seeing these themes, and one of the themes is failure. You see that come up frequently. The other is follow your passion. Follow your passion is usually delivered by a billionaire who slipped on a banana peel and is like, hey, do what I did, it's great. I couldn't go with failure, though, Doris, and I'll tell you why. By the time I graduated from UC Irvine in 1985, I'd embraced quite a good deal of failure in my life. I had dropped out of high school when I was 16. I took a GED, started junior college, dropped out of that, went into construction, masonry, quit that. So, you know, I was pretty adept at failing. What I think I want to speak about today is something I found far more challenging and something you're going to encounter, and that's success. Success is a really challenging thing to manage for a variety of reasons, not the least of which is our expectation of what it's going to provide. A lot of us are quasi-insurgents. We kind of come out of nowhere and we get some level of success, then it lets us down. Not everybody comes out of the gate a Kobe or a Serena. You know, we come from nowhere and we get a little bit of success, and for some reason it doesn't provide for us what we think it will. So I'm going to speak a little bit about my situation, what went on, and how I dealt with that. I told you I dropped out of high school when I was 16. I got a lot of life experience for a few years. It's a nice euphemism. I traveled. I didn't do much of anything. But eventually, I got 60 units from Fullerton Junior College. And that was a really, really big deal for me. I got my associate's degree. That meant I could transfer to a four-year school. And not having graduated from high school, that meant a lot to me. They didn't have the Common App back then, so I drove to New York City to apply to NYU. That didn't work out well. The rejection was a long ride home. But once I got home, I came up with a new plan. UCLA. It's a great school, right? We've all heard of UCLA. I'd grown up being a basketball fan. That's reason enough to want to go to UCLA. John Wooden delivered all those national championships. I'd made a campus visit. It wasn't a proper admissions tour, but I saw the Ramones at Royce Hall. That counts for something. So I call up UCLA and I explain my situation to them. I say, hey, I've got my 60 units, I've got my associate's degree, I want to come be a Bruin. And they listen, and the good news is they said I could transfer in as a junior. They were willing to let me come to UCLA, and I was thrilled. This was a really, really big deal. There was just one little hitch. They were on a semester system. This is March. I couldn't start until September, and I'd already clowned it quite a bit, so I was anxious to get on with it. And they made a suggestion that would absolutely change the trajectory of my life. They told me about a school in Orange County. They told me about UC Irvine being on the trimester system. And I could start there in April, and all the classes that I took would count to going to UCLA. And I thought, well, this is a fantastic solution. I'll go to UC Irvine, and then I'll transfer. So I go over to UC Irvine, I attempt to park, I eventually do. It was easier to park in Greenwich Village at NYU, I'll tell you. But I eventually park and I find my way and I enroll. And a little bit later, I wander over to the Student Center. I had brought a couple bands to Fullerton College. I'd managed a few bands, I booked a nightclub on Sunday night at this one place. And I said, hey, do you have anything like that at this school? Do you have like a person who brings bands to school? And they said, well, in fact we do, we have a position called the concert commissioner. Commissioner, okay. So the concert commissioner is responsible for bringing artists to the 2,000 seat Crawford Hall auditorium. And there was another position called the soundstage commissioner. That person would bring bands to the 400 seat soundstage. Well, I applied for both of them. I figured, hey, if I don't get one, I'll get the other, right? I get both of them. I get both jobs. I don't know if nobody else applied. I don't know if it's because I'm considerably older than everybody else. I have a little experience, but I get both jobs, and it's fantastic. I mean, I'm having the time of my life. We do two shows with The Cure. We do two shows with Oingo Boingo. I do the Red Hot Chili Peppers. I do George Thorogood and the Destroyers, Social Distortion, Romeo. I'm having the time of my life. So much so that I decide I'm not going to go to UCLA. I'm going to stay right here. Now, I don't realize it at the time, but this is the foundation of my career. This is absolutely the foundation of my career. The relationships and friends that I would make back then, I have to this day. So it's Saturday in June, and I'm graduating over in Eldridge Park before Bren Center was built. I've already got a job. On Monday, I start work at Avalon Attractions, the largest concert promoter in Southern California. They're doing four shows with Bruce Springsteen at the Los Angeles Coliseum, 80,000 people a night. He's doing his Born in the USA tour. And I've made a relationship with these people, and they need some extra help. For this, I will drive from Costa Mesa to Encino every day. They'll pay me $250 a week, but I'm in. And check this out, graduates, okay? I feel like tribute to my father on Father's Day. I'm gonna give you the what it was like for me story. My first year out of college at age 26, I made $11,000. So, you know, be patient. Again, what one thing's not like the other, I'm sure you'll all do much, much better than that. But I was in, and I was tremendously excited. But I noticed something. Anybody my age that I encountered was way much further along. And anybody doing my job was a lot younger. I was behind. I was way behind. So I came out of the gun like a bullet, and in very short time, I made up for that. In about 5 or 6 years, I eventually transferred over to A&M Records, one of the great record labels in Los Angeles, founded by Herb Alpert and Jerry Moss. In the 60s and 70s, they had Peter Frampton, Carole King, Cat Stevens, Supertramp. I would be working on records by Janet Jackson and Sting, Brian Adams, real closely with Sheryl Crow and Soundgarden, Blues Traveler, Gin Blossoms, a lot of great artists. And I got this big job. I'm senior vice president, general manager of A&M Records. I'm making more money than I ever thought, but something weird has happened. It's some inverse correlation. The more money that I made, the greater my discontent. You know how it is where you think, hey, if I get here, it'll be great. You get there, but you gotta get there, and then you get there, and then you gotta go there. I just couldn't get there. It was like some weird emotional twilight zone. And I never could find the satisfaction or the contentment. In his book, The Road to Character, the great New York Times journalist David Brooks talks about resume virtues versus eulogy virtues. Resume virtues are those which you bring to the marketplace, right? The things that help you in your career. Eulogy virtues are kind of what you'd expect. It's what people would say about you when you pass away. I had the resume virtues down. If you needed a marketing plan, if you needed to know the right entertainment lawyer, if you needed to contact MTV or a radio station, I had that, no problem. But at this point in my career, at this point in my life, in my personal relationships, I was feeling really, really alone. Something wasn't connecting anymore. I wasn't alone, it was alone on the outside. I wasn't alone on the outside, it was on the inside. You know, I was breakfast, lunch, and dinner every day. I was going to a concert at night. I was busy, you know? But at this point, all of my self-sufficiency, all of the external approval, all of the achievement and success, they were no force. It was right at this moment, at age 35, something incredible happened for me. I get a phone call out of the blue from Columbia Records. Columbia Records is one of the oldest record labels in the record industry. At this point, it's also the biggest record label on the planet, the most profitable record label. And they call me and ask me to be president of Columbia Records in New York. It's a huge job. I'd be the youngest record company president ever. The deal is like NBA money. It's crazy. I've got this friend in Nashville, Scott Lee, really great guy. And Scott has this line that really slays me. It's just unbelievable. Scott says, in life, you get the test first, then you get the lesson. If you don't learn the lesson, you get the test again, and again, and again. I was getting a test. And at this point in my life, I had to figure out the lesson. In my proverbial road not taken, I passed on that job. The chairman of Sony, who's the parent company of Columbia Records, called and said it was the stupidest career move he'd ever seen anybody ever do. All right, maybe, perhaps. But what would have happened had I taken that job? Well, my mom and dad still lived in California. They were getting older. I'd had a very turbulent adolescence with them. I dropped out of high school, I had legal issues. It wasn't great. But as they'd gotten older and I'd gotten older, we'd gotten very, very close. I loved them dearly. My dad died in 2008. My mom died in 2012. It is without question the greatest honor of my life that I was able to help those people get across the finish line in dignity and in comfort. I wouldn't have met the incredible woman that would become my wife. I wouldn't have the four amazing children that I have today. There's a whole host of phenomenal friendships that I would not have developed. In his song, Forever Young, Bob Dylan, in the very first verse, talks about, may you always do for others and let others do for you. I was learning about this. I was learning about what being available for other people, being of service to other people is about. But just as important, if not more so, I was learning to accept help. I was learning to accept kindness. If you think that's an easy muscle to develop, ask yourself how well you take a compliment. It's not easy. It's not easy. I wouldn't trade any of these things for any resume virtue. Not at all. Graduates, you're going to be successful. It's not a mistake, excuse me, it's not a mistake that you're here today. It's not by accident you're graduating from one of the elite institutions in the world. You're going to find success, that's for sure. But at some point you'll hit a crossroads. You'll slip from sunlight into shade. Something will happen. It might be a breakup. It might be a career slight. It might be a death. I don't know. But many of the things that you've learned here, that we learned here about the human condition, about pushing past what is superficial, about going beyond what is comfortable, will come into play. I don't know what it'll be for you. It may be Kierkegaard. It may be Emerson. You might find solace in Joni Mitchell's Blue Album. I don't know. But I ask you one favor. Save just a little room for Otis Redding, okay? That's all I got. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, Jim, for sharing that amazing life journey. So, now is the time to recognize those we have come to honor today. Associate Dean Susan Charles of the Graduate Division, please present the candidates for the degrees of Master of Arts from the School of Humanities and Master of Advanced Study, Master of Public Policy, Master of Urban and Regional Planning, and Master of Legal and Forensic Psychology from the School of Social Ecology.
Will the candidates for the degrees of Master of Arts from the School of Humanities and the Master of Advanced Study, Master of Public Policy, Master of Urban and Regional Planning, and Master of Legal and Forensic Psychology from the School of Social Ecology please rise and remain standing? Provost Lavernia, I present the candidates for the degree of Master of Arts from the School of Humanities and Master of Advanced Study, Master of Public Policy, Master of Urban and Regional Planning, and Master of Legal and Forensic Psychology from the School of Social Ecology.
You ready for this? I'm gonna do this now. With the authority vested in me by the Regents of the University of California, I confer upon you the degree for which you have been recommended by your faculty, admitting you to all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities which pertain to those degrees. In testimony whereof, you will receive the diploma of the university. Dean Miller, please come forward to congratulate the recipients.
We now come to the part of the ceremony where the graduates are recognized as they cross the stage. As graduates exit the stage, they will receive a gift from the UCI Alumni Association to welcome them into the Anteater alumni family. While the process will take some time, we are continuing this tradition at the request of the students whom we honor today. Associate Dean Chen, Professors Wu and Roberts, please come forward to recognize the graduates from the School of Humanities. New masters, please come forward to be recognized.
Jamie Ju.
Christine Nguyen.
Sophaline Chuang.
Mary Green.
Jonathan Aguina.
Rovi Seng. Ganindu Abasakaira. That concludes the presentation of master's degrees from the School of Humanities.
Dean Miller, please present the candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Arts from the School of Humanities.
We can't forget the graduates from the School of Social Ecology. So before we get to the undergraduates, Associate Dean Matthew, Professors Curry and Turner, please join me in recognizing the graduates from the School of Social Ecology. New masters, please come forward to be recognized.
Nelly Perdomo.
Patrocinio Martinez Cerda.
Derek Gaffney.
Marta Ramos.
Maria Soval.
Christopher Chrysostomo.
Maria Beatriz Gaduan.
Joshua Phillips.
Jasmine Garcia.
Patrick Nicholas.
Kathleen San.
Jocelyn Harris.
Deanna Hutton.
Tessia Kim.
Martha Zaragoza.
Nicole Kelly.
Preet Kashkla.
Adriana Alexis Castillon.
Heidi Yonamine.
Natalie Servaisian.
Jian Cha.
Eliani Miranda.
Tong Zhang.
Emily Croson.
Wenyi Li.
Aaron Bell.
Shen Xing Ma.
Natalie Lopez.
Jung Yang.
Brittany Amani Stallworth.
Lunan Su.
Samantha Harper.
Shuki Lewis. Shakira Lewis.
Heidi Alexander.
Nella Coleman.
Amanda Marie Wagner.
Rodrika Jennings.
Lauren Seekender.
Taylor Facey.
Joy Antoinette Goings.
Sarah Dawuji.
Savannah Doherty.
Natalie Graffio.
Iris Muhia Coban.
Stacy Johnson.
Kathleen Shelton.
Andrea Gutierrez.
Irene Aceituno.
Mandy Till.
Emily McKinney.
Benjamin Robertson.
Mandolin Mendoza.
Emily Lin Vu.
Diana Sophia Leica.
Lisa Hamui.
Chase DeRiso.
Jarek Columna.
Jackie Apollo.
Ace Willie Jackson.
Sergio Rosas.
Skylar Greenberg.
Joel Lassard Houston.
Stephen Haram Kim.
Kyle McCoy.
Nayeli Gutierrez.
Hannah Chabon.
Zachary Mogadam.
Catherine No.
Alex Kessel.
Sean Sau.
Jordan Thomas Wills.
Veronica Alexander.
Corey Witter.
Derek Taylor.
Sol Lee.
Oscar Carias.
Robbie Schultz.
Eduardo Bueno.
Nathan Lacey.
Joanna Gutierrez.
Isaac Mireles.
Monica Gutierrez.
Kyle Guy Weber.
Desiree Fuentes.
Molly Mendoza.
Alexander Valdez.
Serena Basra.
Paulina Smakowska.
Justin Hong.
Jose Armenta.
Emily Chen.
Sharif Elmala.
Junan Shu.
Brian Eskew.
Roland Shi.
Lawrence Ho.
Chi Bing.
Emily Rose Phillips.
Sue Lee.
Caitlin Elise Williams.
Minkyu Park.
Sonia Terutunian.
Pei Zhang.
Haley Neufeld.
Haobo Ni.
Caitlin Tower.
Yun Tan.
Sarisa Rivera.
Kang Chen.
Braylin Havig.
Jingan Chen.
Yans Fresha. Marco Iniguez. That concludes the presentation of master's degrees from the School of Humanities and the School of Social Ecology.
All right. Now for real. Dean Miller, please present the candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Arts from the School of Humanities.
Will the candidates for the degree of Bachelor's of Arts from the School of Humanities please rise and remain standing? Provost Lavernia. I present the candidates for the degree of Bachelor's of Arts. Dean Guerra, please present the candidates for the degree of Bachelor's of Arts from the School of Social Ecology.
Will the candidates for the degree of Bachelor's in the School of Social Ecology please stand up? Associate Deans Matthew and Professor Curry? Is that right? Huh? Provost Lavernia, let me present to you the candidates for the Bachelor of Arts in the School of Social Ecology.
All right. You are ready, aren't you? With the authority vested in me by the Regents of the University of California, I confer upon you the degree for which you have been recommended by your faculty, admitting you to all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities which pertain to those degrees, in testimony whereof you will receive the diploma of the university. And now, new bachelors, I invite you to take part in a time-honored academic tradition. Since the days long ago when students were first identified by the caps and gowns they wore, those who had not yet earned a degree wore the tassel on the right. When the degree was conferred, the scholar turned the tassel to the left and joined a select company. So now, following that academic tradition and in recognition of your new status, bachelors, turn your tassels.
Bachelor's degree recipients, please be seated. Our heartfelt congratulations to you and your families. Associate Dean Chen, Professors Wu and Roberts, please join me in recognizing the graduates from the School of Humanities. Bachelors, please come forward.
Darice Smith.
Deanna Judy Jundi.
TK Su.
Alexis Maria Rodriguez.
Jaudi Wu.
Kristen Capayas.
Xing Fu.
Men Sui.
Viola Pan.
Jing Zhang.
Cloris Yin.
Chandler Lee Wise.
Xiaoshen Wang.
Yinong Wu.
Rongsen Shao.
Hong Ang Chu.
Mokan Wang.
Yuxing Cha.
Crystal Shi.
Juan Bolivia Jonas.
Xiaoyu Wang.
Ryan Hanasho.
Hugh Shi.
Todd Siseng Fa.
Siwei Lu.
Madeline DeLuca.
Yue Wong.
Natalie Handelsman.
Tianyi Liu.
Charlie Chavez.
Hongrei Hu.
Mindy Vu.
Jiansing Yong.
Jayling Toh.
Jiaman Du.
Matthew Quintanilla.
Monica Halaka.
Michelle Kang.
Mina Halaka.
Koi Duong.
Alexandra Shao.
Jasmine Adams.
Junghoon Wei.
Tariq Almahida.
Angel Cook.
Kayla Sky Jang.
Kayla Amazon.
Dominique Oi.
Joanna Meza.
Samantha Herrera.
Serena Lee.
Maria Parada.
Alexander Richardson.
Petra Dela Cruz.
Daniel Calvert.
Alejandra Aguilera.
Dilusha Werasinghe.
Casey Nguyen.
Angela Yoshida.
Maria Alvarez.
Alma Rincon.
Eileen Angel Mirabal.
Patricia Perez.
Monica English.
Monica Gomez.
Bita Shehi.
Melissa Alvarado.
Rebecca Grace Worthington.
Mira Dubay.
Eunice Medina.
Danielle Flores.
Audrey Casas.
Shirley Nieto.
Diana Morales.
Catherine Robles.
Randy Chavez.
Ellen Matarosian.
Erica Higby.
Oscar Magana.
Audrey Fong.
Chuman Zhang.
Julianne Elizabeth Vu.
Zara Hashim.
Annalisa Adriana Gomez.
Qingyi Shen.
Corey Lind.
Vivian Lau.
Matthew Sun.
Karen Mena.
Michael Guan.
Christina Mendoza. Claire Jocelyn, Harvey.
Jocelyn Asuenza Contreras.
Chloe Holden.
Liliana Lucas.
Courtney Kukulis.
Noah Kim.
Raymond Stevenson.
Daniel Rowe.
Rosaura Uribe.
Aliana Reed.
Elizabeth Zane.
Skylar Lee Romero.
Shasta Gilmore.
Shannon O'Connor.
Rachel Nelson.
Ruben Cota Jr.
Gabriela Hernandez.
Vaughn Edgley.
Lisa Garguena.
Hunter Hermanson.
Adriani Youssef.
Jacob Alarcon.
Samuel Kim.
Sandy Vu.
Marcus Lewis.
Grace Chatuta Sangsawat.
Cynthia Hernandez.
Riley Murakami Sangsawat.
Jennifer Baldibia.
Mimi Eng.
Stephanie Ornelas.
Christina Nguyen.
Christina Lopez.
Manny DeLeon.
Elena Amaya.
Hayatham Chahabi.
Stella Kim.
Isaiah Contreras.
Sochil Nguyen.
Luke Cho.
Christina Batishev.
Chachi Angela Hong.
Ryan Timberlake.
Yura Rowe.
Christine Ha.
Ya Jen Wu.
Courtney Franco.
Jesse Menares.
Lindsay Stoneman.
Jessica Guadalupe Ramirez.
Matthew Woods.
Natalie Marie Wright.
Phuoc Trang.
Ni Hong Mai.
Richard Ong.
Jessica Castilla Laguanas.
Thomas Wong.
Tyler James Akin.
Reba Reyes.
Kelsey Coe.
Cecilia Flynn.
Caitlin Olivia Hortato.
Jamari DeClue.
Maritza Sosa.
Dracheng Dai.
Elise Diaz.
Kyle Kemper.
Melissa Nicole Alvarez Rocha.
Bradley Cash.
Jessica Peregrina.
Kim Hu.
Natalie Hernandez.
Lizette Lopez.
Gabriela Ruiz.
Zuri Ching.
Amanda Jackson.
Samuel Magno.
Tiarica Garner.
Javier Jimenez.
Susie Hernandez.
Monica Pedraza.
Risa Ogawara.
Yesenia Hernandez.
Ian Morales.
Andrea Coyoy.
Alexander Carranza.
Stephanie Castellanos.
Trisha McGaffey.
Alexandra Sinka.
Shannon Danner.
Angelica Jau.
Alexander Gutterud.
Hannah Hong.
Javier Burdett.
Glenn Castile.
Ben Lee.
Kyle Wynn.
Danica Rain Wong.
Sheen Takos.
Katie Lam Shing.
June Lee.
Marie Pack.
Olivia Morrison.
Cassie Audrey Del Rosario.
Chantal Gonzalez.
Jacob LaCava.
Michelle Sosa.
Mei Chen.
Riley Tatum.
Zamir Ramirez.
Jenny Lee.
Ashley Alvarez.
Phoebe Chan.
Colin Averill Murphy.
Vanvi Pham.
Karen Bailey.
Ivana Dong.
Samantha Oswald McLaughlin.
Paulina Suarez.
Andrew Kroger.
Kia Khalili.
Kalisha Ferris.
Matthew Tran.
Liam Bloom.
Shirley Yang.
Aaliyah Bastian.
Lu Huang.
Tina T. Vu.
Can Lu.
Stephanie Allen.
Becky Wong.
Darian Montes.
Jocelyn Perez.
Lindsay Mendez.
Giovanna Morales.
Wei Long Gu.
Tyler Michael Story.
Miko Nazihong Zhao.
Henry Pineda.
Andrew Giuliano.
Matthew Pagano.
V. Nguyen.
Lilibeth Garcia.
J. Jarvis James.
Estella Esquivel.
Annabelle Tata.
Alexa Arachiga.
Adonijah Green.
Carla Alaya.
Jose Batacan.
Adriana Rivera.
Jimmy Vang.
Nelson Colunga Hernandez.
Catherine Creslin.
Nicole Kim.
Angus Wu.
Adrian Sanchez.
Sergio Vejas.
Michelle Metza.
Henry Gong.
Nona Nguyen Lee.
Johnny Din.
Maribel Valentin.
Daniel Aquino.
Nicole McCarthy.
Teresa Yoon.
Danielle Pagan.
Yoon Han.
Yiju Chen.
Saul Lopez Pulido.
Sarah Jarahian.
Liam James Withrow.
Nina Federizzo.
Andrew Perkins.
Lydia Sid.
Michelle Koski.
Caitlin Etchison.
Martin Villa.
Ashley Duong.
Christy Duan.
Caitlin Antonios.
Bronte Hawkinson.
Natalie Gonzalez.
Kevin Dallase.
Oboni Hosane.
Alessandro Luli.
Denise Martinez.
Kathleen Kim.
Magali Salas.
Jessica Carrias.
Berenice Tepazano.
Nathan Dawi.
Jacqueline Huang.
Chin Ro Lee.
Un Jiang.
Erica Baker.
Ye Lin.
Taryn Lee.
Andrea Hernandez.
Venezia Peralta. Jason Freitas.
Kevin Merritt.
Noah Boltice.
Thomas Ong.
Camila Dadaboy.
Joan Salcedo.
Justin Holby.
Nathan Yan.
Jamie Michelle London.
Madeline Gonzalez.
Justin Parcio.
Myra Varelas.
Castrojón. Jacob Joseph Castrojón.
Jeannie Huang.
Ivan Guitran.
Kevin Chavez.
Brett J. Weisberg.
Aliyah Feline.
Lauren Limbach.
Angel Okor.
Zachary J. Wiley.
Matthew Morris.
Jennifer Nguyen.
Shayla Richardson. Seema Mocha.
Christina Marie Hughes.
Lovejit Singh.
Lindsley Mercado.
Sarah Brandenburg.
Ileana Meyer.
Mario Acevedo.
Antonio Morales.
Ebony Bell.
Elise Hughes.
Sophie Prettyman Beauchamp.
Christy Nexon.
Gabriella Dosta.
Elizabeth Donaldson.
Ariel Verdugo.
Joaquin Cardenas Jr.
Angelique Dagdag.
Annette Lamb.
Joshua Laprame.
Dominique Rama.
Patrick Parducci.
Brooke Denny.
Brianna Carmen.
Which one? Lay or Lee? Kathy Lay.
Abigail Coffing.
Moses DeLira.
Natalie Myers.
Mitchell Taylor.
David Kaufman.
Kyle Ramos.
Faustino Centeno.
Brooke Morris.
Eric Sanchez.
Chase Robinson.
Casey Bass.
Brennan Kevin Valance.
Ariana Barreo.
Jackson Bryant.
Dylan Bloxham.
Aiden McGee.
Matthew Manet.
Sarah Lathrop.
Long Ton Kyle.
Katrina Lombardi.
Alma Pontoya Aragon.
Karen Hardison.
Jessica Rodriguez.
Bradley Seward.
Roya Aminpour.
Lexi McLaughlin.
Atiya Tagi.
Amber Nakvi.
London Webster.
Alethea Ball.
Lars Broussard.
Kyle Christopher Liu.
Julius Baronio.
Annie Tassawar.
Franco Solis.
Kai Wong.
Brandon Kalopoli.
Lupita Carrillo.
Eric Johnston.
Christian DeMesa.
Sandy Bong.
Jennifer Fan.
Rodrigo Quesada.
Carlos Mendoza.
Dylan Hidalgo. Ximing Zhang. Jingjing Guo. Dustin Newman. Leon Wett. Sydney Lara. Holly Dunlop. Amelia Williamson. Janelle Eggleston. Mikhail Babayan. Linnea Togood. Emily Biles. Alejandra Martinez. Maria Alvarez. Sarah Gamboa. John Reed. Nicole Saunders. Sophia Gonzalez. Selena Marie Cardenas. That concludes the presentation of bachelor's degrees from the School of Humanities. I call upon Dean Guerra.
That concludes the presentation of bachelor's degree from the School of Humanities. I call upon Dean Guerra.
Okay, now it's our turn. Associate Dean Matthews and Coutine and Professor Curry, please join me in recognizing the graduates from the School of Social Ecology. Bachelors, please come forward.
Cindy Tsai.
Kanho
Audrey Mosley.
Brian Lee.
Jillian Shea Villarreal.
Melanie Desiree Young.
Katini Pumchan.
Maitri Spence Sharp.
Lizelle Fulgencio.
Camila Ruiz Hinker.
Reynes Garcia.
Isabel Chow.
Caitlin Sauve.
Courtney Johanna Winters.
Sage Mist.
Abigail Canada.
Edgar Perez.
Sabrina Nguyen.
Lauren DiRusio.
Naren Chung.
Jasmine Baxter.
Frances Balboa.
Perla Rivera.
Nina Marikian.
Stephen Wilson.
Jiyun Kwan. Edith Elizabeth Hernandez. Komal Bisma Gias. Audra Shum.
That concludes the presentation of bachelor's degrees from the School of Social Ecology. I call upon Dean Miller.
Thank you and congratulations to all. There are very special guests here today who deserve well-earned recognition. They have encouraged and in many cases made great sacrifices so that the graduates before us could further their education. Now, will the parents, spouses, significant others, loved ones, grandparents, children, friends and relatives and supporters of the graduates, please stand for a round of applause. We salute you. Please be seated. And now a moment we've all been waiting for. Our thanks to all of you and congratulations to the graduates. Graduates, raise your hands and join me in three very, very, very strong, loud anteater zots. Ready? Zot! 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 Ladies and gentlemen, the commencement ceremony will now conclude with the recessional march. May I request that the audience remain seated until the recessional is completed? Thank you for participating in today's ceremony.